Eddie from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna take a look at a very special offering from Best Tech Knives. And it's a very, very small but really well made and well executed folder, something that you don't see that often in the knife market. And it is, of course, the BT1705A. A stands for the particular anodizing job that is done here on this knife. The B version has a silver finished milled out pocket here on the outside. Very, very small and slender, and also very lightweight. But the materials and the craftsmanship that you have here on these particular Best Tech knives are the same as you have on their larger, more full-sized offering. So very, very interesting concept that you have here on the 1705. And I actually wiped this down with some Windex before doing the review here, so you can see the gorgeous anodizing colors that they could get here on this knife. You have different anodizing here on the chamfers and the sides of the titanium scales, on the clip, as well as in the lock bar cutout. Then you have a gorgeously anodized green little pivot color right there, but you actually have some splotches of pink in the green here that you can notice now that it's wiped down. Don't know if that was intentional or not, but really, really nicely done here. Very gorgeous. I don't know if the colors are a little bit too much, so maybe they could have done the pivot color in a gold, so everything would have a two-tone kind of look, but they actually went balls to the wall with the colors here and made all of it nicely anodized and very, very bright colors that they could get here on this knife. And then here in the back you have your little fold-out lanyard attachment point that is actually anodized in this pinkish color. You can see it's not all the way through. You have some gray spots here on the edges where it touches the scale, but you can see it actually works quite well with this little fold-out feature. Pretty interesting and something you don't see that often on a knife. Other than that, we have S35VN here for the blade. Gorgeous blade shape, of course, not too large. We're gonna take a look at the specs later on. Here, S35VN is marked on the blade, and it's first production run number 43 of 100. Now let's take a look at the specs of this very, very small and pretty, pretty gorgeous knife here. We have an overall length of 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of this knife of 2.375 inches or 6 centimeters and a handle length of 3.125 inches or 8 centimeters. We have a blade thickness of around 2.5 millimeters here. You can see the tip here in the front, certainly nothing that you want to pry with. We have a flat grind here on the blade, some nice media blasted blade finish, the newer Best Tech Knives logo, and just very, very nicely contoured and milled titanium frames. No internal skeletonization, but because of the size and the weight, that would certainly not be necessary. You have a stainless steel lock bar insert that you can see here by the screw that also features your over travel stop. Maybe you can see it from this side here. You have this little tab that extends past the lock bar that acts as your over travel stop, so you cannot overextend the lock bar here. And on a smaller and thinner knife like this, I think the over travel stop is certainly a needed feature. You have a 3D milled titanium pocket clip that carries a little bit high for the size of the knife, but I think most people will throw something like this in their purse or in the fifth jeans pocket that you have on some jeans as a secondary carry. But certainly a very interesting overall design and certainly very nice materials for a knife of this size, something that you don't see that often. Now let's take a look at the weight of this small little titanium folder, and we have a weight of 39 grams or 1.3 ounces, so certainly super, super lightweight, and that's not something that would surprise you if you take a look at the size of this knife, but really, really well done here. Overall, I'm just a fan of this little thing. It's just so well made and so unexpected for knives in this size range when you compare it with what's out there in this size range apart from this particular knife. And ergonomically, it actually works quite well. You can see I can even squeeze all my four fingers here on this handle, and you know I have small to medium hands, so if you have larger hands, this is certainly a 3 or even a 2 finger knife, depending on your hand size, but it actually works quite impressively well for the size that it is, so it's actually a usable tool with a nicely thin edge, great steel, and a very attractive and also useful blade shape here in the front. And also, there are not really hot spots on the handle. The clip runs light here in my hand where I don't feel it, so pretty well done there. You have a little bit of a guard with the flipper tab. You even got some nice jimping on the flipper tab right here, and the action is absolutely amazing for the size of the knife. And you can see it even falls into the handle. But of course, the blade is so lightweight, so you have to give it a little bit of a shake. But the detent is perfectly dialed in, like on a full-sized flipper from Best Tech Knives. Just flies out of there, and free-falling blade. Of course, you get the same ceramic captured ball bearings here in the pivot point, as well as the ceramic detent. And also, your blade wraps around the stop pin here in the back when you're opening the knife, so it's just a miniature version of one of their higher end full titanium folding knives in the large size, so very, very well done, and also probably a little bit harder to do everything in this miniaturized form factor than if you have a large folder to do all those things. Lockup here is rock solid, up and down, side to side, absolutely nothing here, and just this stuff really impresses me. If you can do it on a small size like this. You know, I'm a little bit into watches as well, and I think these two things are very, very interconnected with these small things that work flawlessly together. I think they have done that here really well. We have the signature Best Tech Knives pivot with this little slot screw that is very easy to adjust, and then we have a stainless steel torque screw here in the back, so only 2 screws holding this knife together, as well as the screw for your stainless steel lock bar insert and the pocket clip. If you take a closer look at the blade here, we can see you have a gorgeous blade shape, very, very nicely done. I actually would like to see a 3-inch version of this particular knife. That would certainly be a nice EDC piece with this very useful and gorgeously executed blade here. Just really nice. I actually would like to see if they could put those first production markings on the spine of the blade, or just hide them away somewhere, just so you don't clutter up the blade. I think the logo is nicely placed up there. Just really well done, and actually in use, I used it mostly around the house or as a secondary carry knife, just to open letters, opening packages and things like that. Nothing really hard use, or also not a lot of cardboard cutting, just some light use around the house, and for that it's certainly a great, great piece. And also as a secondary knife that you want to use, for example, for some light food prepping or something like that, a knife that is always clean and very, very, very sharp. This is certainly a great little option there, and certainly is also a little bit of pocket jewelry, especially for women. I think this could be a great addition into their purse or something like that, so they have a great, reliable, high quality knife on their person that also looks very, very gorgeous. If you take another look at the details here on the handle, you can see all the machining work that is done here, and the fit and finish and the anodizing. Everything is so well executed here. The finish on this little lanyard attachment point is a little bit rough, and also the anodizing is not that even here on this particular point. But other than that, here the backspacer with some jimping fitted really well. We have a perfectly centered blade. Just nice chamfering all around. 3D contoured handle. Just really, really well done. Now let's take a look at the sharpness. I now had it for a couple of months and used it, as I said before, for some light tasks around the house as a secondary carry blade. And just to see how it performed, it came extremely sharp from Best Tech, and you can see it's really a functional and very, very sharp knife. And it's certainly a knife that you actually can use for some work despite its smaller overall form factor. And it still performs really well here with that S35VN blade steel. Certainly a great choice, especially at the price point. And for a knife of this size, you don't see that premium of blade steel used in those knives very often. So pretty cool that they went all out here on the materials on the 1705. Now, you heard the specs and saw the knife a little bit, but it's always hard to see how large or small things are on videos and on pictures. So now let's do some little size comparison. So first off, I have a Victorinox Cadet as a good size comparison, a very common knife, and you can see those two are nearly identical in the overall size, but here you have a ball bearing pivot, you have a flipper, and you have a locking knife, as well as a much, much better steel there. Ergonomically, this is also better than the Cadet, but on the Cadet, of course, you will have additional tools. Then next up, we have a very, very inexpensive knife that is also in the small form factor, and that is the Sanremo 604, one of these little Sanremos that I have around just for some random stuff, and because I think some of the designs are quite interesting. Here you can see the 604 is even a little bit shorter than the Bestech 1705, and certainly a great little knife for around $5. Very, very handy to have around, this little tanto here from Sanremo. It's also chisel ground, as you can see. And then the next comparison I have is from Boeker Plus. It is the FR, great Brad Zinker design. This is going to be a little bit larger in every dimension, or quite a bit larger, and even this is a very small knife, so you have to keep in mind how small here the 1705 is. You can see cutting edge wise, you actually get quite a bit of cutting edge for the overall size, so blade to handle ratio on the BT1705 is quite good, but this is a main carry for me. I carry this sometimes as my main blade and it performs really well. And you can see this one is just a little bit too small to be my only carry. You see it here in the closed position. This also gives me a full forefinger grip and a hand feeling feel, so that you can really do some actual work with it that goes beyond the light tasks that I would do with this knife here. But actually the action is slightly better here on the Bestech, which is quite impressive. And the last comparison here size wise I have the Chris Reeve Nandi, which is also quite a small gentleman style knife, certainly also pocket jewelry, and you can see here that the BT1705 is also quite a bit smaller than a Nandi, and a Nandi is certainly not a big knife. You can see here cutting edge wise you get even more on the Nandi, and just very, very small here the Bestech BT1705. But now we have seen it in comparison to all other small knives, and it's always hard to put that in perspective as well. I have here another really nicely anodized Bestech knife. It's the Dolphin, and here you can see the actual difference to a real full-size 3.5-inch folder, and you can see it's very, very small. Now let's talk about value and price. I come to a final conclusion about this knife. So you can get this little high-end flipper here for just under $100. You will find a link to my recommended retailer in the description below. It is White Mountain Knives on eBay, and it has really great prices as well as very reasonable and fast and reliable international shipping. So check him out if you're interested in any of these knives. And I think it's certainly, for a smaller knife like this, it's harder to justify spending $100 or more, but you have seen the Nandi, this costs around $400 and is only slightly larger, and there are a bunch of smaller knives that are higher in price. And I think at this price point, with the materials that are used, the attention to detail, the perfection that you have in the milling and the assembly of this knife, as well as the all the anodizing, stainless steel inserts, ceramic bearings and detent, it just adds up to a lot of costs in the manufacturing and also in the value that you're getting with a knife like this. And if you're looking for something like that, a higher end pocket jewelry style of secondary carry blade, or a knife for your girlfriend, mother, or your significant other, this is something that I could see a lot of people that are not really knife people liking, just because it looks gorgeous, it looks cute, it is not threatening to anybody. Certainly an interesting piece here from Bestech, something out of the ordinary, something that you don't see every day. So this was my review. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please put them down in the comment section below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.